Panama Canal. Waterway in Panama. The Panama Canal is a man-made 82-kilometer waterway in Panama that connects the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans and separates North and South America. The Panama Canal runs across the Isthmus of Panama and serves as a passageway for maritime traffic. Panama owns and administers the island, which is 40 kilometers long from shore to shore. Ships can cross in either direction, and the journey takes around 10 hours from one side to the other. In terms of passage conditions and tolls, ships from any country are treated identically. Before the Panama Canal, ships sailing between the east and west coasts of the American continents had to circumnavigate Cape Horn in South America. A journey that took about 2 months and was 8,000 nautical miles longer than traveling through the canal. Bypassing through the canal, all voyages between the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans are cut by thousands of nautical miles. Building dams on the Chagres River to create Gatun Lake and Lake Madden. Digging the Gaillard Cut from the river between the two lakes and over the Continental Divide. Building locks between the Atlantic Ocean and Gatun Lake to lift boats to the lake and another set of locks at the end of the Gaillard Cut to lower ships. And digging a channel to the Pacific Ocean were all part of the Panama Canal's construction. The Panamanian mountain range extends the entire length of the country, including through the canal zone, albeit it is lower there. In addition, the waters on either side of the Panama Canal have different tide levels. Ships are raised to the level of the lakes, which cover about half of the canal's length, and then lowered to sea level using locks. The Panama Canal was fully controlled by the United States, who built it. From its opening in 1914 until 1979. Control of the canal was transferred to the Panama Canal Commission, a joint U.S.-Panama organization, in 1979. And entire control was transferred to Panama at noon on December 31, 1999. The Panama Canal Authority, which reports directly to the Panamanian government, is in charge of canal administration. Vessels going from the Atlantic to the Pacific reach the Lyman Bay Approach Canal, which runs for nearly 7 miles to the gut locks. A set of three locks at gut elevates ships 85 feet to gut lake. The 166 square mile lake is constructed by the gut dam on the Chagres River and supplied by water from Alajuela Lake. The waterway that runs through the lake is 46 to 85 feet deep and stretches for roughly 23 kilometers to Gamboa. The Gaillard Cut starts at Gamboa and runs all the way to the Continental Divide. The channel via the cut is around 43 feet deep on average and stretches for about 8 miles to the Pedro Miguel Locks. Vessels are lowered 30 feet to Miraflores Lake, which is 52 feet above sea level. Vessels then transit through a 1.2 Yojakchin MILE long channel to the Miraflores two-step locks, where they are lowered to sea level. The canal's final segment is a 7-mile long dredging approach channel through which ships enter the Pacific. The canal has a minimum bottom width of 500 feet along its length. The width of the channel varies between 500 and 1,000 feet in Gut Lake and 740 feet in Miraflores Lake. The canal locks are powered by gravity flow of water from the Chagres and other rivers, which feed the lakes of Gut, Alajuela, and Miraflores. The locks themselves are uniform in length, width, and depth, and were built in pairs to allow vessels to transit in both directions at the same time. Each lock gate has two hinged leaves that are 65 feet wide and 6.5 feet thick. The gates range in height from 46 to 82 feet and are moved by electric motors hidden within the lock walls. They are controlled from a control tower, which is placed on the wall that divides each pair of locks and also controls the flooding and emptying of the lock chambers. The lock chambers are 1,000 feet long, 110 feet wide, and 40 feet deep. Only tiny ships are permitted to pass through the locks without assistance due to the sensitive condition of the ancient lock systems. Electric towing locomotives, which move on cog tracks on the lock walls and keep the ships centered in the lock, guide larger craft. A fender chain, strung between the approach walls, must be passed before a lock may be opened. That chain will be lowered into its groove at the bottom of the channel if all goes according to plan. If the ship is going too fast for safety, the chain will remain stretched and the vessel will run into it. The chain will then pay out slowly via automated release until the vessel has come to a stop, which is controlled by hydraulic mechanism in the walls. If the vessel gets away from the towing locomotive and rams the first gate by breaking through the chain, a second gate 50 feet away will protect the lock and stop further progress. The third set of locks projects third lock systems, which began in 2007, were inspired by the Barendrecht lock in Antwerp, Belgium, and water-saving basins seen in German canals. On the Atlantic and Pacific sides, 190,000 tons of steel, largely from Mexico, are embedded in extensively reinforced concrete. In the new lock gates measure up to 33 feet wide, 98 feet high, and 190 feet long. The additional chambers and basins, which will manage the flow of water from Gut Lake, were designed to reduce turbulence in the water flow and vessel disruption. The basins, which included 158 valves and 20,000 tons of structural material, were finished in June 2016. Officials claim that the water-saving basins are the world's largest, allowing for 60% water reuse. The new locks use 48 million gallons each use, compared to 52 million gallons for the existing locks. In both oceans, long breakwaters have been built near the approach channels. The breakwaters on the west and east sides of Lyman Bay protect the harbor from severe gales, while the one on the east decreases silting in the canal channel. A causeway stretches from Balboa to three small islands, Naos, Perico, and Flamenco, on the Pacific side, diverting cross-currents that bring soft material from Panama City's shallow harbor into the canal channel. One or more pilots board each ship before it leaves the terminus and guide it through the canal. Ships may take up to 25 hours to navigate the canal, depending on the amount of time they have to wait. Once a vessel has been given permission to proceed, the typical transit time from one end of the canal to the other is roughly 10 hours. Canal traffic normally flows in both directions while the Gaillard, Culebra cut is not being deepened, despite the irreversible loss of enormous amounts of water with each transit. Operation is possible due to Panama's abundant rainfall. When their sizes permit, two or more vessels going in the same direction are passed through together to save water. Measurers board each ship to verify the ship's carrying capacity and collect tolls. Manifests, ship papers, and other documents are scrutinized and documented. An automated marine traffic control system schedules and monitors transits at several points along the route. Hope you have enjoyed watching the video. Do like and subscribe. Keep watching all our videos.